Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I lied. I did have one more Roush replay for 9.16. It just happens to be a Rumba. He's rocking the long gun. The long gun, as opposed to the short fatty, is more accurate, faster firing, and higher penetration value. Why would you ever use the shotgun, you ask? Well, because it's a derp cannon and it's hilarious. People don't like it when you're rocking the derp gun. Your allies have created Platoon 3. Fantastic. Seriously, guys, you're rocking a Hellcat and you're in people's way? How does that even happen? I bought me a Ferrari. I just keep it on the, in a lot downtown. God. Humans. The upside, if you are totally unfamiliar with the Rheinmetall Bossig Waffentreicher, aka the Rumba, aka some people call it the Waffle, but we generally reserve that for the higher tiers. Okay. Hello, sir, with the E25. So sorry! The other thing is that the camo is pretty darn good. However, they have slightly messed with it and nerfed the camo in a previous patch. Hence the damage to the gun. And he's also missing 22 hit points. It's not a bad trade-off. Yeah, if you can hit the Rumba with an HE round, you are doing very well for yourself, and he will be very sad at you, and very angry. Which, actually, I was in exactly that opposite position. I was rocking my T-29, and, I put a big old HE round into the motherfucker, and did a lot of damage, and set him on fire, which killed him, and he was a sad panda. It looks gonna enlarge this mini-map. This is the new, I think in the next patch that I have not grabbed yet, there are a lot more of these high-def mini-maps. I like this. This is very nice. I may keep this annoyingly large. A little pot shot. You never know. I'm not really sure what our Yag Panther 2 is doing up the hill, but I'll let him do what he wants. It is the Yag Panther 2, and the Yag Panther 2 does whatever the fuck it pleases. And you will thank him for doing so. There's a little adorable E25 up on the hill. Kill it. Kill the skillet. Wah, 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 wah. Look at all the idiots we have, not actually in our base, but kind of looking at our base. A lot of fire downrange from a lot of low caliber guns that are just not getting the job done. Pardon me, boys, this is the Chattanooga Choo Choo. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. T-29 with a magical enlarging gun mantlet. OP, OP. Dang. Well, T-29 running away. Good choice. This is the weirdest match I've ever seen. We totally, clearly have control of the hill, but we can't do anything with it. And we've completely given up control of our own base, and yet they can't take it. I am totally confused. And we're down by 5 tanks. Scratch that, 4 tanks. Our world beater Hellcat is dead. After camping the base for reasons unexplained. Hello! No, 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 you hold still. T6, delicious. See, this is how you play Hellcat. I mean, ordinarily you'd be a lot more successful than that. But you go out and you do things with it. You don't sit around at home. You don't park in front of everybody trying to be a dick. What is that? He's not behind a dead tank. You notice that all of the green, dead green stuff in our base, our Super P, I guess, decided to drive right out to the front line and eat shit for a living. What the hell's that behind him? Skoda? Because that's a good idea. The Tier 6 VK sat in base for no reason. Awesome. I love it when base campers just eat shit and die. And then they start screaming at us. Ooh, hello sir! Welcome back to the party! Oh my god! Right in the gun mantlet! Ah! Roush is pissed. I can tell. Roush is mad. This guy's gonna get a fucking beating. We got a KV-5 on a hill. We got a VK who doesn't understand that rocks exist. Jesus. We got a heavy tank number 6 on the back ass side of the hill. We got an OI that's been hanging around as far away from battle as possible. I don't really blame him because the OI in this particular case is not going to be very successful either on the front line or trying to sneak around. Hello, good sir. How might I assist thee in removing some hit points? Fire? Yes, fire. Quite good. Covered in bees! Our leopard is doing a good job just sitting and spotting. He needs to remain undetected so that we see all of these shenanigan heads trying to come after us. However, if that Super P waddles this way, it's not going to happen. He's going to get the proxy spotted for sure. What is our artillery up to? It's got 2 kills. I ain't gonna talk no shit. And there goes the leopard. Damn it. So the OI, even though it's as big as a house, okay, it's as big as 2 houses, this is only a tier 6 and a tier 8 match. So he's a giant target with not enough armor to stand up to anything. And his gun is better suited to blasting people in the butthole than really anything else. If this was a tier 6 game, I'd be yelling at him. The heavy tank number 6 has finally got his stones together and polished them up nice. Yeah, no question, Leopard Dude, you did great. Hello, E-25. You are a one-shot. We just need that targeting information. Lead the target. He's going too fast. E-25 is great. Bam! Oh, yeah! Called it! Nice. And remained hidden. There's a Rumba back here. Well, I mean, remained hidden in as much as if the guy doesn't have target markers on, they won't be able to pinpoint the exact pixel of your location, but close. Oh man, I haven't played back in this corner in forever. This used to be an actual viable technique. They've changed a lot of things since I started playing. And you used to be able to get back up in this corner and everybody else could just run away from base, and one person could hold this off. Ooh, we're clawing our way back in. Yak Panther 2 is raining down hell. Dun 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 dun. Roush is rocking the all of the big heal kits, as well as the binoculars and the camo net. And, apparently incendiary rounds, because that's delightful. Oh, hello, sir. If we get one more person to just shoot him a little bit, we would... Okay, well, we'll do all the work then. As long as everybody else bounces while we reload. No. We're not done with you. Not in the gun mantlet. It sank over the hill and dinged him in the tracks? Really? Ooh, that was close. Oh... Bet you that hit him right in the gun mantlet. There's just pepper in the back corner. Well done. See, that's what target markers will do for you. Break the game. You know exactly where he is, even though he's completely hidden from view. We need to find that KV-2. Our KV-5 is down. So, heavy tank number 6 bit it a while ago, I guess. Ooh, nice. Oh, that's not what we want. Nope, nope, nope. Nope. Artillery on our team is doing the thing. We are not spotted technically yet, but he knows exactly where we are. Oh, thank you. Woo! That's all you need is a fully loaded AMX 5100 just bleh, all over your face. Not in a good way like you want. Well, good news. We have a bunch of hard cover between us and them now. So that's handy. Yeah, previously there were no buildings around Cap, if I remember correctly. It has been quite a long time. Hello, side of the turret. Thank you. 19th time's the charm. We do have a top gun. But we keep losing people. Our OI just got terminated with extreme artillery prejudice. Let's see. KV-2 on Cap or the E-25 on Cap? KV-2 was last spotted closest, but the E-25 is really the only one with enough camo to make this a viable opportunity. Because that KV-2 will be spotted very easily. Dun 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 dun. Hello! E-25 called it. Come back here. Come back here. Come back here, motherfucker. Oh god, it's the KV-2. He missed. Oh good. Woo! Pass off. Still doesn't take any damage. Pancake. Pancake. Come on, let's flip over the pancake. Can we get a little assistance? Assistance? Mr. JP2? We really, really, really don't want to go out in front of the KV-2 and the artillery. That is correct. Rabbit Hotman, as I like to call him, is correct. We need support. We need that JP-2 to get in this bitch. And there you go. Artillery on point, son. Now, we're trying to lose connection with the world. We don't want to be spotted. But we want to keep control of the situation and murder all of the people. Ding! Didn't get spotted either. Camo OP. Roush is laying that heavy artillery downrange, son. Woo, child! That's 7. Now, it's a race. And since it's a race, the Yag Panther 2 will probably win to find that artillery piece, unfortunately. Whoa, god, fuck off. And Roush is taking the long way around to do it, so I don't really think this is going to work out for Radley Walters here. Yeah, Yag Panther 2 has a fucking blazing engine on it. It's one of my favorite Tier 8 tank destroyers. It's one of my favorite tank destroyers, period, really. But that Yag Panther 2, he's going to hunt that sucker down to get him. I don't think Roush is even really concerned at this point. He switched back to regular ammo. He doesn't even have HE loaded while he's hunting for artillery. And the JP-2... Oh! Well, you know what? You know what? No. Oh, the live long fuck! Damn, yep, yay, JP-2. Well, he had a shot at it. Had a legit shot at getting that Radley Walters. That was fucking close. Well done, clawed all the way back from... Well, you know what? Once you get rid of the really, really bad players on your team, sometimes it's easier to play when you're down 4 or 5 tanks because you don't have the jackasses in your way. Oh, man, let's look at the final battle results, and then I'm going to upgrade to 9.17, And we're going to do another Roush replay with the new Tier 8 heavy tank, the Immel. Oh yeah, jawohl.
Ja und hello. We have the Rumba results, we got the Ace Tanker, we got the Arsonist, we got the Bruiser, we got the Top Gun, and we got the High Caliber. And we almost got the 100k of the profit. Well, we will see after taxes and the premium ammunition, but otherwise, yeah. A ton of times three victory, so I can't hold that. Actually, the German and the Russian accent I can hold together pretty well for a while. But it gets tiring. Got himself 6,282 XP on a times three. His crew is in pretty darn good shape, I would say. 5,351 damage, 7 kills. The Tiger P did almost 2,500 damage with 4 kills. Yag Panther 2 over 2k with 2 kills. Everybody else can suck eggs. KV5 did 1,500 damage. It's acceptable. Everybody else kind of threw themselves into a fire. The Leopard, no damage, which is incredible self-control. Leopard Rabbit Hotman from WUN2. Is that a Linux joke? I don't know. Anyway, did pretty well for himself. And by pretty well, I mean pretty darn well. He said 3,600 spotting. I have no reason to doubt that at all. Their artillery got 3k damage and 3 kills. Their E5P got almost 1,200 damage. KV2 got 1,200 damage. That's to be expected. It's KV2. I mean, you're in a tier 8 game. That's just more opportunity to get more HP in your bucket there. E25 got 1,000. The other E25 got one shot off and died like a dog. What did our Hellcat do? Where's the Hellcat? Hellcat got 2 shots off and 8 shit. God damn it, what a retard. Let's see. 17 for 21 shooting with 13 penetrations. Total damage aforementioned. From beyond 300 meters, 2,379. Pretty good. Received 1 hit. It was a non-penetration, damaging the gun. Got 2 hits received. Results of splash damage. 2. Okay, so they were both HE rounds. Shot 8, killed 7. Got 68 defense points. Not quite enough for the defender medal. 341 due to assistance, because we pinned that guy to the ground. And after taxes, we made 6,700 and 478. Goddamn, that was stupid. I just screwed that up. Oh well, stay in the video. Basically, his little battle payments, I'm not sure what that's all about, but I'm sure somebody could explain it to me. That paid for the ammo that he used, and barely had to do any repair costs at all, and did it all in less than 15 minutes, obviously. Alright, now, time to upgrade to 9.17 and see what's available to me to harass with the KV2. Peace!